show on the road again, because
yeah,
it sounds like we got a ways to go.
But yeah, so we have a cleric
bound down.
Loaded up and
thank you, Joseph SSJ for following us. Thank you for the follow, my dude.
Anyway, so picking back up, top of the order.
Yeah,
America,
top of the round.
Oh no, this one's green.
Ain't that is that Joe or is that
Ireland?
No, it's a green hag.
It's the chickadee.
That she is going to be under the snow.
She is unaffected by this. Thank you for reminding me, because at the end of your turn, y'all need to be making wild magic. I forgot it. We're not going back.
Oh!
Oh, so, let me get the wild magic.
Oh, wait. I get my 5 HP back, because end of turn, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Hey!
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay. How many more turns can I have that? How many more turns?
I would say 3.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so, you slam. You were a camel.
Yeah.
No, you're not a camel. The hag seems amused. A fireball happened and shit. Like, she starts spinning her umbrella and flung part of the fireball back and just goes,
"Oh, you are just fucking annoying."
I know. She is going to roll an ass like a 20.
Uh-oh.
And then roll it. Not a nat 20, but a 23.
Both will hit.
Okay.
At least it's not an ass 20, though.
Okay, so that is...
Shit.
It's fine. It's cool.
That is 23 damage on the first one.
Oh.
That's a lot of damage.
And, that's more betters. That is 9 slashing on the...
So 39.
Second one.
So 32.
I
love how Google knows everything I'm going to type before I type it.
I was really hoping for just the "that's a lot of damage."
That's a lot of damage.
That's all right. If it comes down to it, I can just hide out in a server closet.
You're just gonna like go back and hang out with John Deere in the Wendigo room?
Nah, I work tomorrow. If I drink too much,
I teach kids tomorrow.
I have Heidi holes,
which is why I'm watching what I'm drinking at the same time. Big liver.
I just have
Jake from Adventure Time.
I just have to make some wax ups tomorrow.
I just have to.
You need to print my character so I can. By the way,
your character is printing right now.
Tuesday, I do need your help to flip stuff up and get the bonfire ready. If you can come over,
I can.
So we're doing that Tuesday.
Yes.
Cool. We can pull stuff off my wood pile if needed.
We might.
Look. I am just making teeth all week.
Con save. Who's closer, preacher?
Oh, I don't even make one.
No, it can make two attacks on somebody next to it and launch one spell.
Okay.
12.
Fail. So that's 1. 8.
Ow.
Total. I'm totaling up 8.
Who needs teeth?
13.
Does anyone need teeth? That sounds 20. Weird when I say it.
My girl actually
27.
Does.
Okay,
I can help you.
28.
Does she just need just a, like, one little thing?
31.
Okay. What the?
36. How many have I just rolled? One more.
Oh my. What?
That was 30. What?
36.
42.
Okay. Wait, do y'all have insurance?
You got any more?
No, necrotic damage.
I have insurance.
Okay, because I was down like 5 rolls ago.
Yeah, I'm just, okay, total amount here.
We can figure something out.
Okay.
Just give it.
Total amount here. Is 42,
you said.
2. What's your max HP?
72.
You're dead.
No.
What?
Wait, you're resistant to necrotic.
I am resistant to necrotic.
It's 50%. I think it's if you hit 50%
max. That's 20.
So.
But I still had 19 HP.
So you're down, but you're not dead dead.
No, I'm just although down.
I got, Chris, would you go let dog out as this thing casts Blight?
Oh my Jesus. God.
Well, she only had that one spell slot for it. So knock creature down.
Okay.
Creature, give me a death save.
Already?
I mean, it's your turn next.
Oh, so it is. 16.
That's a pass.
I'm going to stand back up. I'm going to hit her with the might of Paler.
No.
No.
You don't recover. You're just...
Oh, not yet, but give me a couple of turns. I'm going to stand up and I'm going to smite
her. Give me a minute. Give me a minute. I'm going to get back up and she's going to have a what for.
I just got a gut punch, okay? So just give me a sec.
Does
I'll stand
throw
back
anything
up.
At Joe?
She slashes Joe twice.
So did we already do that?
And blights.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sorry.
And then it was Preacher's turn to death save. Now we're waiting on the person I just asked to go let the dog out, who I think also went outside.
To get another beer.
There's beer in the inside fridge.
Not beer. Apple juice. We're not drinking on stream. That
That's bullshit we're drinking on stream. We're grown-ass people. Bug it.
Mm-hmm.
We are trying to raise money next weekend for children, but we are not 100% child-friendly, and I have a child, and I'm still not child-friendly. The child has made me less child-friendly.
Yeah?
Because my child is a mini-me, and that dude is an asshole.
Yeah?
What do I want to do?
To be fair, I answer to asshole.
That is also true. I'm still kind of sad Cannon's not making it.
Yeah, I am too. By the way, Neysa, if you yell, hey, asshole... 90% of the people that are going to be here next weekend will answer to it. Unoffended.
Nice.
Hey, asshole.
Hey.
See?
Nice.
Did you go and get more Cheetos?
Mm-hmm.
It's your turn.
Okay, so what happened?
Preacher's down. Preacher's down because he got blighted.
Ah, Egypt!
You just watch as the hag slash, and then bops the ground with its staff, or bops the ground with its umbrella. And you watch as these sickly lines hit Preacher and he goes, "Lack!" And you're like, thank God it got him.
Is there still a body?
Yes.
Yeah, there's still a Preacher body.
I'm still alive.
Uh-oh. I thought Chris was going to reach back for a Reese's. This is how I feel about this shit. I got candy.
I feel like even in Jesse, I'd still be yelling obscenities.
Bubblegum and taffy, skip to the sweet shop with your sweetheart Sandy. You got a penny safe, so you're a sugar daddy.
Okay, I know what to do.
This complicates what I was trying to do. Is there a tree or is something for me to hide my friend's body around?
No, not. Well, you could drag him, but I don't think you could drag him there effectively.
I am not going to attempt that. I am just going to try to make sure he is not dead.
No, he's unconscious. What you doing?
I am going to cure wounds.
Okay. Do you give him a little stew in the mouth, though?
I do give... That is how I cast cure wounds.
Just tilt the head back. Hold it right here.
A little thyme and rosemary, some salt, pepper.
Little ash keeper.
A little bit of ash keeper.
Are you just putting paydays up here, Rick? I'm just restocking your paydays.
I love paydays.
You rolled an extra 20, so you got
He just puts another one right there.
This is going to give me the biggest.
I keep forgetting there is paydays here. They are a very good
I still haven't ate one of these yet.
Why?
They're good.
Take one.
Amazing.
Is that traffic over there? There's paint. I see paint. Oh, God. The DM's gonna fall.
Oh,
die.
It looks like...
No.
You okay?
No.
Little chappy sticky?
Is it not over there?
Little chappy sticky.
It looks like when you have drawn this. I am very sorry
for
that. I also
sent a selfish bungee flying somewhere. We'll find it later.
Did he tell you about the bungee?
No. Check your temperature. Okay. Is it high? Okay, then he's being a butt. Probably. He was watching a lot of that,
Maybe he ate a lot of candy.
No, I've been keeping an eye on that. The one that has, like, three babies, yo-yo, whatever in Baby George or whatever it is.
Coco Melon?
Yeah.
Why are we letting watch Coco Melon? It's for babies.
He was watching it on YouTube. I gave him the iPad. I'm now in trouble. I don't know where the chapstick is.
Anyway.
By the way, stream, I am in trouble.
11 HP.
Yeah!
Squeeze. No more death saves, no more death saves.
I get to release.
And then I just hide behind your body.
Are you going prone?
I'm going prone behind the body.
You could pick me up.
Which way are we doing this?
I am maneuvering the body strategically.
Like, are we doing this number?
So I can JoJo approach.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That would be up to him.
Are we both laying on the ground then?
Yeah. I'm good.
You don't have to be down here too, Medrid.
Okay. And then bonus action, going to basically go like...
Inside free.
Right there.
Hey, Misty Step!
Face step back. I'm going to face step back. Then that she is still underneath the effects of Fairy Fire.
Yup.
Big money no whammies.
2 17s on the die, so 24 to hit.
Yeah, that'll hit.
Okay.
We're looking for that crit.
That the first attack is going to be...
Do it. Stop trying to find peanuts that I dropped, because I didn't.
No, wait. 8. Another 11. All right, second attack.
Look for the crit. Come on.
These are the ones that normally crit. Okay, 14 plus 17 is... I mean, 14 plus 7 is a 21.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay. And that's going to be 9 points of piercing. That's just 2 arrows just knocks into her.
And at first... Mm-hmm. You know, oh God, I'm gonna mess it up. Now you have her attention.
Oh.
First, you had my curiosity.
You had my curiosity.
You got my attention.
Oh God.
This all of a sudden just shifts into Robert, Robert DiCaprio.
I'm getting. You must be the Belmont.
Leo DiCaprio.
Robert DiCaprio.
Leo. Yes, Robert DiCaprio. Leo DiCaprio's brother that was in the made-for-DVD version.
Robert De Niro DiCaprio.
Yes. Now you have my attention. Yeah.
Are you not entertained?
To be fair, you are the Belmont is one of my favorite scenes. They're like, oh, because Trevor has weak-ass punches. Like, no, Dracula's like legit sitting there going, there's only one family of dumbass motherfuckers that would come up and punch Dracula in the face. Like, ah, you're a Belmont.
Nope. It's beautiful.
30, by the way.
30?
30 what?
Ooh. To hit?
No, a 30 on the thing we have to roll. Because of the snow.
Oh, shit. You both should have already rolled. So, 30.
You should
have reminded him. I'm sorry. I am bad.
Spence, take a point of inspiration for that. You got 30. You teleport up to 60 feet away into an unoccupied space.
Oh, bye, Spence.
Oh. Not all the way over there.
Up to.
Like, you can't cross my line.
Get in front of me. I need help.
It was already there.
Okay, what'd you get, Preach?
43.
12, about. That's about.
For the next minute, you can teleport up to 20 feet as a bonus action.
Oh. I love Madrid. Or Edred.
57.
Edred.
For the next minute, you are flammable to anything.
I'm already flammable.
So it means if something hits you, you catch fire.
You will spontaneously
catch fire if anything hits you.
So to be clear, Jolan poured it all the way, but I'm like not actually in my space, right?
Why don't you pour it over this way so you're not across the line into shit?
Yeah, get out of my line.
Get out
there
of
you
my
go. Yeah. That's clever.
So, yeah, if anything hits you, if you move...
Oh shit!
If I move,
yeah,
you are extremely.
You're flammable to anything.
You are crabgrass.
Not Henry Crabgrass, though, which is a cute T-shirt.
Okay. Is this?
It is now your turn.
All right.
They are prone with your blade in them, pinning them.
I would like to inflict wounds. It's technically a melee spell attack, but since I'm right there, do I need to actually make an attack
roll? You need to make an attack roll with advantage because it's a touch spell attack.
All right. It's trying to sling that other hand around here. Got a plus 7. Don't fail me now. 23.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to channel my last channel divinity. I can do an extra 5 plus twice my cleric level necrotic damage on top of the damage of the melee.
Which is 11.
My cleric level is 6, so double is 12, plus 5 is 17, plus my 3d10.
Hold on. Say that. What does it do with the Reaper ability, or the Death Cleric?
It's 5 it's plus... 5 plus twice my cleric level. My cleric level is 6. Double that is 12.
John cheated me on damage. So that's 5 plus 12, so that's 17.
17 plus the 3d10 off of, yeah.
That's a lot of damage.
That's a lot of damage.
I'm raging.
I would like to rage. You're not a barbarian.
I am right now. All right, that is a lovely 19 plus 17.
For a total of...
Good God.
34.
19
plus 17 is 34.
Wait,
19
plus
17
would be
36. Oh, yeah, that's right, 36. Math is hard. Why was I here as 15?
You drop this into her, and you watch bits of this hag explode off. One eye erupts into explodey goop.
Good.
Jelly.
Snarling all the while. Oh, hell.
Ow.
You got attacked by your tactical.
What are you doing?
I took one dice bag damage.
Okay. So,
all I can think of is that I'm sad about Dimebag Daryl.
I love me some Pantera, even though fucking Dylan Zama is kind of racist.
Oh, no, I'm not a huge Pantera fan. I still just feel bad for Dimebag Daryl, like, having someone walk up on stage.
Dimebag Daryl is great. Dylan Zama is not.
At the same time, on the same note...
Cowboy from Hell is really good.
Dylan
Zama is just
everybody
not really
being mean
good.
To Adam Levine freaking out about a fan getting on stage and hugging him out of nowhere while he has his eyes closed mid-song can kind of fuck off, because that would freak me out too.
Okay.
Dimebag Daryl.
Okay, so like fans getting on stage and doing like fuck shit like that, like I can agree. Like, don't fuck with like
let them do the show. Let him do the show.
Unless you're at, like, the shit I go to, where, you know, it's meant to be, like, a mosh pit and shit.
Can I twist my war scythe as a bonus action?
You twist it, and she is not happy about it. It doesn't do extra damage.
Come on.
but... Okay, first attack, because she is pinned, is going to miss. Second attack... He's going to miss, but I need you to give me a wisdom save.
Yeah, that's all right. I can do that. That is a 22.
Fuck.
Ha ha ha. My rage is working.
Yeah, get fucked.
I'm so mad that spells don't affect me. Yeah, they do.
I feel like you got the easier one to deal with.
Well, I mean... The DM might have decided, oh fuck, she decided to attack on her own. Don't throw the anise hag at her.
Alright, can I then, do you want me to make that,
make that D100 roll.
And regain my 5?
Yeah, and you regain your 5. The spell does not,
21.
Reroll, because we're already done this one.
Alright, stand by. 62.
We've already done that one. Roll again, because I don't want you to just sit there and be shouting while my child's got to go to bed.
5. 0, 0, 5.
Uh-oh.
Bring it.
I think it's the one.
See that?
All of a sudden, as you're stabbing her...
Okay.
On top of her head, all of a sudden... You see this little one-eyed creature that's like got a round body, little spindly mechanical legs, little spindly arms looking around like,
On top of her head.
Just lands on top of her head. Steps off like... And it's holding a gear like...
Why is that a fucking
like, drum? You just hear... What? Like a little toot toot from out of a vent on the side of its head. It is very concerned. Elsa has very large pillowy lips.
It is a Modron.
It is a Modron. A Modron just appeared off to the side. Why did they have to give Modrons and do Modrons? They gave all of them the lips.
I don't understand.
They gave them the nice sexy lip.
Okay.
Is it like a little automaton?
It's a small automaton from the world of Mechanus that very rarely is seen outside of it, and it is confused because this is not its directive.
Okay. I'm ignoring it. I mean, I'm not ignoring, like, I'm acknowledging its existence, but, like, I'm focusing on keeping her pinned. I'm keeping her pinned. Like, this is my goal right now.
Okay.
Well, that was back to the top of the turn.
What would 100 be?
Duo 8, 100?
0, 0, 0.
It's going to
be... 3 zeros is 100.
Okay.
I thought it was 1 and...
No,
that would be a 1.
No, that'd be
3 zeros is 100.
Because the zeros are 10.
Okay, so... First round, or first turn, it's over here. Mom? Yeah. The two of you are prone, so give me dex saves at disadvantage.
What's she doing?
Me?
She casting a spell. There's nobody right next to her.
Okay. Does it happen to be magic missile?
No.
Oh. You're hoping for that immunity. Mm-hmm.
Oh, back to death saves.
Right. Wait, are you dead?
Not yet.
No, it just
not
has, yet. Like, has a very low amount of HP. And the two of you are in a straight line.
Yep. What am I rolling?
Dex saves at disadvantage, I believe.
Hold on, let me double check to make sure it's a dex save.
Because we're both prone.
It is a dex save and you're all at disadvantage because y'all laying straight up on the ground.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a fail.
Okay, what was the total?
3.
Okay.
I'm getting the dice. I gotta pick it. I'm sorry.
No, you're not.
I'm not sorry because they don't want to die.
Oh, Burke went up the nose where there's still a little bit of beer hanging out.
Oh, good. Wait, it's a dex save?
Yeah, it's a dex save.
16.
Okay, you'll take half.
Screw you, preacher blindness. What? Oh, I just came back.
Wait, do I get advantage?
No, you had disadvantage because you're pro. So far that's 14.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
That's 3.
14 plus 17.
I'll do math.
31.
Mm-hmm.
31, what's half 31?
Wait, plus 31?
It's 31 damage.
Oh, okay. Good. So I'm safe.
That's 15?
That's 15 to you.
Okay, so... I'm safe. 26?
I'm not dead outright.
15?
Right, you are down.
Yeah, I'm down again.
Okay, how far is she? Oh, she's gonna shift up right to Preacher.
I'm at 11.
Surprise, motherfucker.
Hey! Actually, she's gonna move up to Medrid.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, hello, how are you doing? This is...
Oh, that actually got caught between the DM screen and the dice tray.
Oh, that means I win. You die.
No, that means I rolled a nat 20.
Oh, God.
Oh, jeez. Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
So that is 11.
Yes, I'm down.
11 plus 4, so that's 15 plus... 3.
7.
I am already down.
Okay. Failed 2 death saves as she... Or hold on, let me see if she hits you again. She does, so failed 2 death saves.
Holy Jesus.
Yes. I need a letter.
Just clawing into your side.
Yes, I am very
Preacher,
down.
Death save.
End of turn.
What did you hit?
Oh, God.
Oh no.
Arkin 2 fails.
So both of y'all do me... Both of y'all roll me a D1. Oh, hold on. Edred, because it's your turn next, give me a death save.
Oh, a death save, as you say. Huh? Oh, let's see. I have 1 death save dead.
Oh, no.
You have 2... Did you just fail?
I have not rolled.
Okay, you have 2 fails because you got hit a second time.
Oh, you're a fucking asshole. Oh boy, I succeeded.
What'd you get?
An 11.
Okay, roll me a D100. What'd you get, Preacher?
26.
A third eye opens up on your forehead while you're unconscious and dying. You can see everything and experience everything real time.
Paler has come to me.
But you also have advantage on perception checks for the next hour.
Yay, that's so
Paler helpful. Has come to take me home.
That's so helpful. 35.
Roll me a D10.
I can see the world for what it is.
D10, here we go. It is a 9.
It is time.
You got
9
years younger.
Oh, it doesn't matter. I am immortal, technically.
Technically.
I am like lobster.
How old were you, though?
I was 60.
You're now 51.
Interesting.
You cannot go buy super liquor anymore.
Oh my goodness.
All I couldn't think of was fucking Futurama. It's like, how old are you? I'm only 180 now. I can't rent super porn. Fucking Futurama. Okay, so yeah, that's y'all. Joe, you just watched both your friends go down, and this hag is tearing into Medrid, eating bits as she pulls them back up.
Please help me. I cannot speak.
I think
right
you've
now.
Got range for a big throwdown on the bow. Like
you yeah. should have. I mean, like the if you're talking about a longbow.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're in range. Like maybe take a five foot step forward.
I'm gonna move a little bit forward.
Okay.
I was just trying to figure out what I can do for healing because that I can't use healing spirit because I burnt the other second level spell
slot.
Yeah,
you ain't healing at the moment.
You don't have to worry about healing if she's dead.
Player elimination.
At the same time, y'all got death saves to make. That I mean, Edrid.
What would a healing
might become
spirit
Edrid.
Would
have been? Oh, it's
better
it's
shape than me.
Okay, then at
Preacher.
That,
okay. I might hand you my character sheet.
And the thing is, with this fight, I'm out of the game, technically.
All right, and still going on? Fairy fire still going on?
Fairy fire is still on this girl.
Okay. That is going to be a dirty 20 to hit.
That hits.
Okay.
Hey, not quite what we need, but
still,
we'll take it.
Still looking for the crit.
Yeah. Okay, where is it? I'm pulling out the big guns. Let's see. Wank. That's going to be 7 together.
7 all together?
Yeah.
She's still up.
Nope.
Crit.
Big money, no whammies.
Where's the Tristana? Crit.
Big money, no whammies.
Come on.
Oh, that's not good. That's going to be a 14.
Misses.
Oh no.
She stomp her in the back. She turns and looks at you.
Mm-hmm.
You fire the next arrow. She spins her umbrella. Give me a dex save.
Okay. But that's going to be a 15.
Okay. Roll damage for your arrow normally.
Okay. Ooh, min damage. So 5.
You take half.
Okay, so
she spins her umbrella, it hits it, it flings it back at you, and it goes by your face and gets like that cool little like anime scar.
Mm-hmm.
Kenshin.
No, not cool as Kenshin scars.
No.
Also,
trying to help you out.
It makes me sad what Kenshin's artist got caught for.
Oh,
I don't want to know.
I'm not telling you. I love the anime, I love the manga, the artist is a piece of shit.
Well, separate the artist from the art.
Hard for me to do that.
It can be, but...
Suddenly, Zugar is in the picture.
Vipera.
Deus Ex Machina. Okay, I'm going to Toll the Dead on this
Zugar
bitch.
Zugar just runs
okay,
up.
So
it's a wisdom save.
No, that's a 1.
Oh, it's a 1. Does that mean double damage?
No.
I tried. Okay,
roll
but
your
she
two,
has...
Roll your 2 d12s.
Because she has taken damage.
Roll your 2 d12s.
Ooh. That is a lovely 18.
Well, she had 7 HP. You explode her head.
Good.
Hell yeah. You fucking...
You just do... Like, you do that... Do you have, like, a bell on your horn or something?
Yeah, like, there's maybe little bells in my...
You just
thump
it with the pommel of your pole arm. It's like... Ting-ling.
Good. Now, I'm pulling out my glaive, and I'm going to wherever the tiny building was.
You make it over there.
I want to fling open the doors. Are there kids inside?
There's a bunch of kids chained to the wall. Very fat kids, by the way. Like they are pleasantly plump children.
I'm not thinking about what that means. I'm gonna start slamming chains.
It doesn't break them.
Damn. Okay.
I am on ground. Help me.
Moving on.
I have a spell. Oh, 53.
Oh, wait, actually, Vipera needs to roll too.
Yeah.
53, Joe. You are immune to being intoxicated by alcohol for...
Okay.
Hey!
The next 2 weeks.
Okay, the next 2 weeks.
I can drink you under the table.
All right.
Not really. You're both going to sit there and be drinking until, like, all of a sudden 1 week Joe gets drunk.
All right.
Exactly, and I'll still be sober.
And then you'll except die of alcohol failure. You fucking die of liver failure.
I'm regaining my 5 off the end of my turn.
I mean, you got to let me have
56.
This. Great things are going. I'm going to die from hag poisoning.
Oh,
your hair falls out completely. All the hair on your body just explodes off of you.
Sad thing is, I'm not wearing a full wig cap under this, or I could actually pull it off.
Just.
okay.
Weirdly enough, it just stays.
I'm a Dora Milaje tiefling now. I'll take it. Let's go.
It's just you have your horns, your bald head that's slightly less blue. Just that you open up the door, the kid, you look at the kids. Kids. Not the weirdest thing we've seen today.
I believe it. All right. So you're gonna move on, and I'm gonna try to figure out how to bust these chains.
Okay. Back to the top of the order with this one. Rolling to hit Edred. That's a 17 plus. That's 2 failed death saves.
Wee, I'm dead.
Creature.
Bye, Edred.
That's a 17. Why are you leaving the table?
He's dead.
I'm trying to use the bathroom.
Oh, fight.
You just watch as Creature has a hand. Slammed through his chest, and she
rips
out a heart.
Oh God!
Oh
dead.
God!
Jolan, you might want to run.
Jolan, that is. Hold on. The hag has one more thing. Turns and looks at you, who've been shooting spells. That is a 19.
That will hit.
I guess I can put it.
Spoils of
one,
the boy, you're mine, bitch.
4. 9 necrotic.
Okay.
As a skeletal hand reaches up and just grabs into your abdomen and rips back, tearing a chunk with it.
Oh, Jesus.
Did you just kill everybody?
Yeah. 2.
I killed half the party.
18, 15,
20. Here's the real question. Do we wake up in the real world when we die?
No.
Oh,
no,
God.
I don't think so.
Oh, God.
It's all right. Preacher's ready.
I've got the two of y'all here in a second, okay?
Okay.
So, Edred's dead. Joe.
I am just... Fairy Fire is probably off at this point?
Yeah, Fairy Fire is gone at this point because the person who did it died.
Okay, then.
Like, I don't think that's how the spell works, but I'm going to home rule it that if whoever casts Fairy Fire on you dies... You're not fairy fired no more.
So I'm basically going to. So I am basically just going to like look at her, and concentrate. Does she just going to have a extra mark? So extra damage. First attack, not hunter's marking. It's something that I can do as a ranger a day.
I cannot eat this. My tummy is too full of sugar.
a straight 18 on the die. So then that's going to.
Yeah, that hits.
So where is a d4? D4 plus another.
Big damage.
Hold on, you're going to get your character sheet.
Okay, then that is. So then that's going to be 8, 5, 6. So that's going to be 14 piercing
for the first attack. How do you want to do this?
I basically just look at her and just be like. It has been just one hell of a day. You, my friends, need me. And then that I just shoot the arrow. And then that the arrow just kind of goes in just through that the juggler. But then that as that, you know, that the hit seeps in, that just like the cold, icy firefly just come out of her holes, just eating her insides out.
Her
insides.
Hell yeah. Dude, fuck yes.
Like icy freaking firefly slash locust pouring out of her as she drops dead. Yes. But you also see both your allies have been feasted on. That you're straight up dead.
I'm dead. Hey, your I'm heart a corpse.
Was ripped. Your head heart was ripped out of your chest.
Yeah.
Look, I got a big hole in my chest.
No, this one has like you just have chunks missing out of you. That's like cool. Part of your neck's gone, part of your face is gone, part of your thigh. Your chitlins have been pulled out.
Well, you know, it is what it is.
All right, can we go back to the chains?
Give me an investigation check real quick.
Who?
I knew Eleanor was too good to be true.
15.
She gutted me.
But that's no, that wasn't Eloise.
I know.
But that's going to be 17.
If anyone has,
17.
Like, revenge by, I have a...
You find on this hag a small bag, and as you open it, there's an eyeball blinking at you.
All right.
Give it to me. I'm dead.
I look at the eyeball.
It looks back at you.
Give it to me. I'm sorry.
I am just going to put that the eyeball on even or odd.
Roll.
For them.
Roll. Which one? Even or odd?
I'll pick odd.
You are odd.
Odd. I give it to Medrid.
Hey, Medrid.
Hello.
Actually, what was the last letter that you lost previously?
M.
An ilm.
Before the M.
An L.
So what was that name?
Meldred.
Hey, Meldred.
Hello.
You're now, you have an eye sitting on your chest. You have one HP.
That's weird. That's odd.
It's just blinking at you.
Hello, eyeball.
You know what that eyeball's for.
Friend, how are you doing? I critted the eyeball, and then I'm going...
As you let go, it's not in your hand, you feel it in your body.
I'm going to take the crystal from my pouch and smack it into his chest. And cast Revival Fire.
Alright, what else are you doing to try to get him to come back from Paylor's Domain of Delight?
Hello, you have friend. You have more things you need to do. You need to be completely insufferable for other people in other planes. Come back, you fucking idiot! You ugly bastard!
A flump appears and falls on you and dies immediately.
What?
Flump.
A flump forms in the air above you, falls, hits you, you take one damage.
Okay.
And then falls off to the side and dies. Okay, so here's the deal. You're just yelling all these insults at him. Preacher, would that do anything?
I'm trying to be cute about it, but
her baby daddy Paylor summoning you.
Her baby dad? Oh, they'll fight in words.
They met at the
Cracker Barrel.
Cracker Barrel at the end of the universe.
It's like a dad daughter thing. Oh,
hey, don't ask questions about the guys.
He made her.
Just,
yeah. You want to start getting into freaking morality with the?
I was kind of hoping Paylor would be like, you know, a bit above Zeus here.
He is. Oh. He's more on the line of like Poseidon. It's a slightly above lateral move.
I was hoping for above ball.
My friend.
You were hoping for not the Greek pantheon minus
yes.
Hades.
You have done a great service to me. Please come back and be a great service to other people once more.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you, as your character, how well would this maybe work? As you're being beckoned into the afterlife of the Flare Father, the Harvest Lord, the great... And the great fiery-headed Brosif.
Brosif.
I don't know what Paylor's freaking afterlife looks like. I'm not a Paylorian. I'm over here going, the Raven Queen's going, take me to Goth Heaven. Which just means we all stand in a Hot Topic with Allison Jaffe behind the cash register.
We just stand behind the school going like this.
We all have sage cigarettes. And a bottle of Jameson we stole from Dad's liquor cabinet.
And we're just like,
listening to The Cure.
Listening to some typo negative, like...
Okay, see, you're not describing anything that's not appealing to me.
So I don't think Preacher would listen to anything.
No, no, I'm just saying if that's the case, you're about to make me a D100 roll straight instead of with advantage.
All right, so...
I'm trying...
It's not anything that Medrid would say, but it's that Preacher is a Preacher, and he's one stubborn son of a gun. He's left stuff undone.
I'm gonna say this is just a straight roll still now.
All right.
Straight D100 roll it.
Can I say something real quick?
No.
Oh,
you had your chance.
You had your shot, child.
That's a 47.
You're dead. You go to heaven. Right. Actually, you don't. But hold on to your character sheet. All dogs don't go to heaven. But keep both your minis and your character sheets.
Yeah.
I have use for them.
It's not working.
So.
You keep doing it and keep doing it and keep doing it. Preacher's body stays cold. Meldred.
What did I do wrong?
I'm sorry, like, you got, like, the most backwoods Mississippi old lady name.
Meldred, we need to try to find Vipera quickly.
And you automatically would know it's Meldred now. It's like, it was never Edred, it was never Medrid.
Okay.
We need to get out of this crazy snow. We need to go and...
We must take friend with us. I'm sorry, I didn't
mean to spit. All three of y'all give me a perception check.
Okay.
16.
You notice.
Dirty 20.
You notice.
Notice what?
Meldrew.
I'm in the building. Like
perception?
Building, what's your perception
kid
total?
Jail.
Yes, you're in the juvenile detention center at the brewery.
16.
So you're all going to notice this. You watch as you killed that hag and then you put the eyeball on Meldred. The building starts to collapse in on itself and the hill starts to sink in the same time. So you have all these chain kids. What are you doing? They're screaming.
Can I cast... Are all the chains connected to each other?
Yes.
All right, I want to cast Dispel Magic on the chains.
Okay.
Good?
Yeah.
Good.
The kids, they get up. I got gout!
We're running! Now! Dragging the nearest kids by the
hand. You're dragging this one kid whose legs are just flop. No. The kids are fucking running.
Okay.
They're fucking booking it. It's all just, right. They're like,
We're not gonna, is the hill collapsing?
We are leaving this as quick as a child-filled trip to Joe Exotic's zoo. By the way, there's a season two of that shit coming out on my birthday.
The hill collapsing from top down?
No.
It's donutting down.
It's deflating like a souffle.
We're going toward the bottom.
Okay.
And just getting, like, trying to get out of Dodge.
Okay.
And
oh, look at that! Cleared up.
Oh, good.
me and Joe take.
I don't want to roll for all these kids.
You're running like a couple of the kids turn into fucking cheetahs.
Seriously?
Yeah. Like they run off with like three other like two of the kids turn into cheetahs. They run off with two other kids that they grab and just disappear in the woods. Like just child murder.
Jolene,
roll me a wisdom save.
Wait, what?
The two kids turned into cheetahs and grabbed other kids. And ran off into the woods.
From wild magic effects? Or
yeah.
Shit. Okay.
No, at the same time, roll me a wisdom save to see what happens here. Because everybody's... let me just scratch out...
26.
Oh. Okay, yeah, you good,
me and Jolene are gonna...
Both of y'all give me a wisdom save because this has been a rough fucking minute. I should have made y'all roll at the freaking dock.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna use one of those inspirations.
I think you did make us roll at the dock.
No, I didn't.
I gained one then.
We were too busy rolling wild magic.
19?
Yeah, you're good.
Can I gain back my one last usage?
No, you didn't roll on that 20.
No, my...
Oh, wait, you're talking about
the wild magic HP effect. I had one left when I got to the building.
Yeah, you can still get your five. Then it's done after this.
That's a 19.
Yeah. 19. So you all safe.
I sit here, I'm like... We should get our friend out of here. At the very least, he does not deserve this.
As you're saying that, you watch as his body is just swallowed by the earth.
Oh, God.
Let's you go to grab it.
Go.
Roots, like, you see, like, a root shoot up out of his mouth, wrap back around and go around his neck and just jerk his body down.
Oh, yeah, I'm dead.
Yeah,
we need to go back. And
are you doing like the freaking crawfishing?
I'm doing the crawfishing and I'm grabbing Jolene and
Jolene.
I'm pulling Joe back and I'm like, oh, I'm so very sorry.
It's okay.
So as y'all get like,
they just don't.
And I'll sit here. As the mire fills in, there is no longer a dale. And 22 acres is a large distance, but it's an open thing. You see the two of them across from you. You see Vipera with like probably a half dozen children on the other side of this now 22 acre, which I think is 1 hectare. Lake. I don't know. People online correct me. I don't know how long a hectare, how large a hectare is. I just know that for my old brother, where art thou? The 22 hectare lake. I don't care if it's a 1,000 hectare lake. You're going to go find my ring. To be fair, she right.
Yep.
Yep.
I. There.
All right.
Preacher was a good person. Yes?
100 meters, hold up, a hectare is the equivalent of 2.471 acres.
Hmm. So like a 10 hectare lake.
Okay, thank you.
We should,
all right,
I wish we could have done more. He's...
I'm going to gather up the kids and I'm going to start walking around
both
the lake.
Both of you. Mm-hmm. Y'all... So y'all are gonna move your way around over to her.
Yeah. We're being very careful about it.
Okay, so you're dodging, you're moving around. The snow is mostly melted. You get over there. There's these dozen kids, and you see this one little snapping turtle looking turtle child, wearing a little bow tie.
Hello, child.
Hello there. Bien bonu.
Are you related to Mayor Wilson?
Then my dad, my pa.
Alright, we're gonna get you back home.
No.
No?
They done sold me to Hag.
They
sold me to Hag.
Hag is dead.
Okay, they sold they sold them to their heads. We're not taking them back.
Okay.
We can take them to Eldenwald. I can make sure they are taken care of.
We don't know how to leave.
Yeah, we don't know how
this
to
understand that, but if we figured out how to leave, the Eldenwald will take care of them. I promise you.
So wait, that we had all had visions, correct?
Joe, yes. You said something about a willow tree.
A weeping willow, yes.
What about the willow tree?
It was something about up in my vision. Let me just recall up in my memory.
What is the weeping willow? I'm sorry, I
have been saying it all the time we've been here.
I'm sorry.
Do you know the weeping willow?
It's just been...
it's tree sagging branch.
Yes.
Do you know a really big one?
I am very sorry, Joe.
It is a massive one.
It moves.
Do you know a way to track it?
Where is it?
With your brain.
Okay.
I'm very sorry, Joe. It has been a very weird.
Did we get this kid's name?
Sorry.
I feel like I need his name.
Now, what is your name? What is your name, boy?
Imro.
Imro. Okay. Where can we find this weeping willow?
Show him the map.
I'm gonna show him the map.
I only know the stories that it moved. I'm pretty sure if it's that big, that it gonna leave a trail. But
it's a trail.
Y'all team special. By the way, I'm under the impression that me and my fellow chillins here need to just mosey north and hope that we find somewhere else, because all y'all seem cursed.
Very fair. Would
fair.
you
I'm gonna give
Please
him.
Please wait
Don't
here.
Touch me. You seem very odd.
I am not touching.
You're missing the pinky finger.
It's fine. It happens.
Elsewhere, John has just been pulled in like,
this is weird.
Should I would in
John was the devil's hound in the lake.
I would enjoy them to be in the Elden Wild where they'll be taken care of.
We're not abducting children. If they want to go, they should get to go.
I am not abducting children.
Right.
If they don't want to go with us, they don't have to go with
that
us.
That is very fair. I am not
Why,
saying.
Do you have a place for us to live?
I am just saying.
I ran away from Ember and then found a bunch of ball cutters on the other end of the river and thought my situation was slightly better, and then they sold me to a fucking hag!
Oh, child.
No, this kid has got some anger management. Like, this little fire ganassi just
wants to...
Nice.
I understand your idea of hex are very, very low right now, but my...
I got friends in low places.
Okay.
My people are... Do not prey on children.
Kiddos, we
And
want...
you can, like...
They prey on adults.
Kiddos, we want to take care of you, but if you don't feel safe with us, then you're more than welcome to go.
Then you are more than happy to leave.
Mm. Okay, so you're trying to get them to go to the Elven Wall?
I'm trying to convince them to.
Okay, I'm just saying, make a persuasion check.
I'm making a persuasion check? Well, should they roll insight?
They should roll insight.
Oh.
And I'm going to say right now, I'm not lying.
I just burped and got the tail 19, end of a Reese's 11. Cup.
Ugh.
I'm not lying.
The elven
hags
not
do not
the,
pray.
The kid's like, you see the turtle emerald. So, you would find a safe place for me and all the others.
As long as you...
Include little Lulabelle. And you see this little minotaur baby at the back with a bell on his neck?
Yeah.
Lulabelle will be safe in the Elden Wild.
So me asking at the DM a question. So what about the shoulder burn thing? We took care of the hags, technically.
Yeah, the hand's gone.
Oh. Okay.
Reach in your pocket. You find a solid black business card that as you tilt it, the lettering is in slightly elevated black because, of course, this asshole would do this. And it just...
Is it in a language?
It's a language, no matter what language you speak, you understand it. Lord Ozymandias, Archdemon of the Nine Hells, Chiropractor, Business Benefactor, Lawyer, Talent Agent.
Okay.
Masseuse and nail technician.
It also made me think of that
multiverse certified welder.
It also made me think of that
and gubernatorial candidate for the state of Utah 2022.
What is Utah?
I understand.
Is
it
some Feywild island?
And there is a contact number that you can't read the number, but if you touch it, you feel like you could contact Ozzy fairly quickly.
Look, I understand that...
To be fair, come on, which state would Ozymandias pop up in just out of
California?
Fucking... No, that's too easy. Texas, any red state, any super blue state, no.
Yeah.
Utah, I feel, is like, Utah or North Dakota?
Definitely not Georgia.
No, that state elected green, man. That state would be like, Satan, yes!
Okay. I have no problems as long as we get the kids somewhere safe.
Right.
You have my word. The kids will be safe in the Elden Wild.
They're not safe here right now.
One of the kids looks at you. You swear it on your name.
I swear it on my name.
And her name is very important.
Medrid.
Which one?
Medrid.
I'm sorry, that was me. Is the DM being a jerk? Which name? We've gone through... Five, six, seven thousand.
Oh yes, and then
I understand it's hard to trust hags, but the Hags of the Elden Wild are something better than what you experienced.
We did lose creature.
I'm beyond that right now. Like, we need to be moving. I'm passing the rusty sickle to Emerald. Now, don't use it on us. That's only if we get attacked, okay? So that you can fight.
You're fine.
You won't be able
to. I was saying he just pulls out a couple knives in this hand.
Okay.
Oh, you're very strong.
Excellent. How about we pass some weapon around?
He just he hands some knives around. All of a sudden, now you have a bunch of kids with knives and a sickle in the creepy woods.
I'm not giving one of them the gaff that.
All of a sudden, there's just kids with knives, a gaff, and a sickle just up.
I think we still had there was a dagger or something too that one of us picked up.
You have a bunch of kids with knives.
All right, good. As long as
sickle,
all the kids have weapons
and a pokey stabby fish stick.
All right, now.
What are y'all doing with these kids?
Mm-hmm. Look inside your brain.
Mm-hmm.
Quiet everything down really quick. See if you can find the
if that tree. Can give me the
see
eyeball,
if you can hear
I would give you notes
the
too.
Tree. Okay, something. Yeah. I was looking for the tree.
Put the eyeball on you would
we'll
give
do
me notes too.
Okay. Jolan is trying to meditate
are
for the tree.
Are we in a forest area?
Now.
Okay.
The hill done fell into the lake. Well,
so,
made a lake.
I would like to make a survival check with advantage to see if I can find anything related to a weeping willow.
Okay, roll. Let's do this shit.
Natural 20.
Oh shit! Yeah, you do. Take the buildings off.
Oh,
take erase the put buildings in there and get me every tree.
Oh jeez, I got to put.
And y'all talk amongst yourselves as we're about to get into something because I gotta go potty.
Okay, so. So,
Meldred is back.
Oh, we're putting
baby.
I would think I can
more trees down.
Something.
We're in woods.
We are in the woods.
Woods.
But that we did lose Preacher.
Yeah.
No, we'll bring him back.
I'm dead.
Yeah, that we will find a way to give him a proper. Well, the ground swallowed him up.
Yeah, I got swallowed.
But I could have tried to heal him, but I didn't have enough healing on me. Speaking of which, I need healing myself. Ow.
Would you all like to come to the Elden Wild?
Any place is better than this hellhole.
The Elden Wild is a very good place. It's very good. It is very well established.
I can probably end up just starting up just a new home with just some new wolves, maybe more werewolves that I am used to.
Very many wolves here.
I have exactly one.
Okay.
Exactly one spell slot left of every level.
Yeah, and we're back after a quick break.
Are we still on the audio? That's correct. Okay, so we got everything set up. So you rolled a nat 20, correct? You find, after about a half hour moving through the woods with you, Medrid, and Vipera, and a gaggle of knife-armed children. You gave a bunch of fucking hobbits knives.
Let's go.
You have the Hobbit Knife Squad plus the Tortle with the sickle.
They have to be able to protect themselves.
And one little dwarf kid holding the gaff just coming through like, fucking Robert Swampstoon. I will gets carried off by something.
Oh my goodness.
Comes back 5 minutes later. Fucking stabbed it.
Good job.
Oh my
smiles,
goodness.
And you see there's fucking feathers in his mouth.
You should wear
you
that
are,
for
you
your
are a beautiful person. You'll do very well in the Elden Wild.
Stranger danger. Stranger danger.
I am keeping.
Stranger danger just gets closer to the one that looks like a legit devil.
Madrid.
I am.
Children. They are
she has made a child army of sacrifices.
I am the mother of lost children. Let's go!
You just watch as Vipera goes through the woods like this and all the little kids like baby ducks. Leading them to the...
You're very good at
okay,
this.
Okay, so after a minute, you find this rutted up section of the forest.
I'm sorry,
about 30 feet wide.
Yeah, I'm just talking with her.
It is 30 feet wide.
It's 30 feet wide, and it just goes off to the south, twisting.
Can we tell which direction? We can to tell which direction.
It went south.
Okay.
By the way, the trees are leaned back.
Okay.
You see one of the trees is leaned back, but every so often you start seeing some of those that are further this way start to go.
Can I talk to her real quick?
More trees.
Talk to who? You have to get through my army of children.
Yeah.
No. Because of tree phobia?
Yeah, roll a wisdom save.
I would like to talk to her as we're traveling through this.
Because that's a 12.
Okay, Joe, I got that noted.
Like, I was trying to talk to her.
Yeah, go ahead. I was just, there was a
You're interrupting our
role.
RP.
I'm sorry. Mechanics just happened that are very important for the DM.
Before all that happens, you're very good with children. I'm very sorry.
Hi there. You're creepy.
I'm sorry.
Where's your pinky finger?
It'll grow back.
You're a fucking lizard?
Yes.
Yes.
Fucking wicked eye.
Right?
Right.
Yeah. I understand I'm not very good with this.
I mean,
you're not.
But
hey, I mean,
the little turtle comes up. Yes, go ahead.
At least the children are not biting at you like that the whoop pups used to do.
I'm glad you are here. And
we are too.
Just my smile keeps getting bigger, like I'm good with this.
Until the DM kills all these kids.
I will just sit down and go catatonic. It'll be fine.
I understand I can be a
Please
bit...
Please don't.
I understand I can be a bit too much,
As
but
a parent, I don't know if I can.
I don't think you can.
But
that's not a dare! It's an agreement! Put that look away! Don't make me break out the stare again.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, fuck, that's way better than mine.
Yeah.
Does the blue paint help?
Yes, because also the lack of eyebrows helps. All of a sudden, it's just like... I'm thinking I've almost picked out my eyebrows, so never mind.
I'm glad you're here. You're very...
Responsible?
Responsible, special...
Caring.
She
can fly!
She can fly.
Slap that.
I
gave me a knife.
Calm down.
I said another one.
I'm trying to have a fucking moment here.
Did you see the dwarf kid take the gap back from the one that stole it?
I'm trying to have a moment here. Just
start teaching them techniques.
I believe...
The first kid rolled a nat 20 and stabbed you in the leg. Take one damage, I'm not gonna make you take full, because all of a sudden you're like, this is how you do it. The kid just stabs you right in the leg.
Children know what they're doing.
They do.
Just one of the kids just stabs. I'm sorry.
Are you
just,
okay?
It's like the Ace Ventura dead center of the thigh.
Not necessarily, but fork. It's just all about, I mean, it's just as much as whenever that you're just fighting with wolves and then that they always bite at you.
Another, you see one of the other kids coming up behind.
Okay,
I see you.
Let's not use our friends.
I just push him in the head, like, go away. Don't do this.
As Meldred's doing that, you see two other kids coming up with the knives.
Okay, kids, are friends. We are not attacking friends. We are attacking bad things that want to hurt us.
But they are not of the forest.
Nor am I. I don't belong here.
You're not of the forest.
Are they going children of the corn?
All the kids are staring at you holding the knives.
I am of forest. We are all of forest. We are not of this forest.
I had noticed something, Vipera. You see down south that this 30-foot wide tree thing.
So you're describing that as these kids all hold their knives up looking at you, and all of a sudden the turtle made you flinch.
Good one.
But you're not of this forest.
We're not.
Yeah, we're not of this forest either. We're from the mine.
All the kids
start giggling in unison.
Kids, I understand your playfulness, but I would like to have heart to heart with my friends here.
That's
Meldred.
Fortunate.
Let's
get home. I'll come visit you in the Elden Wild. We can have a moment then.
Just enough.
What are you doing? Okay, straight legit asking you, as the DM, what you doing with these kids now that you found like what looks like tree path?
I mean, I'm trying to, like, trying you to got, RP, you
got
but...
A, you got a tiny murder force with you.
I'm like...
Okay, to be fair, the murder force probably only will murder you.
I have no problems taking them with us. Like, I'm not going to stop to question it. Like, we're going to follow tree path. Like,
if that they follow
these
and die,
seem
very, Joe
very
is just like,
people,
okay, oh well.
They can become very productive people in the Elden Wild.
We got to find the willow first, I think.
And we also have to worry about our dead friend. We are one person short.
You know what? His loss.
Let us not talk about friends.
It's survival.
Actually, the two
survival
of you switch seats
right
for
like,
me real quick.
Oh, God.
My dead friend.
Y'all have made decisions for the DM. Get over here closer to me, new friend. Let me scoot this a little wider.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
Someone move a dice tray.
Oh.
Look, I'm just saying.
Patrice right there. No, I'm not joking. Patrice right there.
Oh, shit.
Look, I enjoy my ugly friend. He is a good person.
I enjoyed him too, but he got killed and we're alive and we gotta get out of here.
This is not a good attitude.
Bickering
to have.
Up in this forest is not going to keep us going.
To
keep going.
I want to.
Because that these trees keep on like dimming the. Just keep on dimming the light. We need to go and then now it's blue and next thing next thing you know.
I'm gonna disappear like a green screen, like
actually a little bit, but it's like nighttime.
Daytime.
Oh cool. I am
very comfortable back here.
Nope.
Alright.
Nope. Let's go now. Let's go and go.
Look,
so
what? I am very sorry. I have to say this. I enjoy our friend Preacher. We need to find a place for him to resurrect. We need to get out of here.
We need to just go find his son.
We are.
The Elden Wild.
Whee!
What knocked over?
Dice box.
Pausing.
No!
Hey, everybody.
No, because now I don't want to step on a fucking dice.
Don't worry, it wasn't any
D4s. It is over here.
Punishment.
Well, there's the box. There's
no
dice
flew around this way.
I don't see anything.
Oh, yeah, they're over there.
There's a blue one.
Yeah.
Dice on the floor.
Danger, Will Robinson. Danger.
But here is the thing.
We're at a code Gygax.
That creature was a good person. Uh-huh. His statue was
six,
very helpful.
Seven. I'm missing a D10, a D20, and a D8. Right there. Watch your feetsies.
No.
There's the two D8.
And what else were we missing?
D20 and a D10. No, I got the D10. Okay, so just D20.
What color was it?
Red.
DM. Cool lighting effects. Fuck. Dice.
Yeah.
You've brought this on yourself.
Okay.
Where is it at?
So
up
maybe,
your nose with a rubber hose.
So as soon as we get out of this place, I will be ensure to basically make sure that we can at least go on one hunt together.
So I'll just work off the table right there.
So let us just
Meldred,
keep on this trip.
I understand that you're upset, but we have to worry about life, not grief. How dare you?
The turtle.
And besides,
okay. I apologize.
And besides, then that
okay.
We may want to keep moving because of the fact
we,
that...
We can bring him back. I believe we can. So at least
we can rebuild him. Stronger.
Let us
faster.
Bring his
better.
Corpse with us.
How? It's at the bottom of a lake.
It's right here. I've been bringing it.
No, that shit sucked. Like, it had a root come
you
through
liar.
The back of the skull around the mouth and wrap
oh,
around the
that,
head and drag it
that
down.
That is the fucking Ash Keeper. I am very sorry. I am sorry.
Yeah, so what have you been hallucinating? this whole time that you know that the
Okay, let me ask you, is this talking and walking, or are y'all just having a existential crisis in the mud pit?
Like, we're
talking and walking. But, like, I do stop for a second and be like, I'm very sorry. I thought we
I'm making a quick perception check to make sure that I don't hear anything.
I know he is ugly, but we should not cast him around.
Okay, hold on.
Sorry, I was trying to free children.
That'll be a 19.
I understand.
You start seeing large roots everywhere that have a slight green
bright
glow to them.
At least that green, it looks like purple.
Meldred, are you okay?
Oh,
I'm not.
so much drink.
Oh, jeez.
It does adjust to purple on the freaking autocorrect.
Look at that.
Whoa.
Hold on. Let me see. What are, if I do this, does it autocorrect anything else?
Whoa. No, it's just pink as fuck. It just puts us in
hell. That's hell.
We're already there.
Ozzy has summoned us.
Nope.
Okay. How about not?
Oh, no, that one doesn't do shit.
Okay.
What happens if we make it purple?
Stand by.
That's worse.
Oh, God.
So, while y'all are basically talking, a short sword goes over Vipira's head.
For the why?
I missed.
Yeah.
You missed what?
Attacking you. You. I missed.
Roll initiative.
All of us?
The three of you. Roll initiative.
That's a dirty 20.
Ooh, but that's not good.
14. Holy shit. That's a really good roll.
Last.
22.
So, Meldred.
What about my gaggle of children army? I can roll for them. You want me to roll for them?
They roll a fucking nat 20.
Oh,
yeah,
God.
Them's my babies.
Okay, Joe.
I got a 14.
Okay, so we are starting with the children.
Yay.
Who are going to descend upon Joe.
Yeah. Oh.
I need somebody to double check this shit.
Oh, shit.
If it's a crit, then...
No. Come over here and...
Oh, yep. That is it. Yeah.
So,
That hurt.
I'm going to say this is the whole gaggle of children descend upon you, and I'm just going to double the raw damage. That is 25.
Down.
You just see the chip, like, all of a sudden swings the sword to you into the kids. Like, just a swarm of knives, and they're still stabbing into Joe's body. Going on next is going to be Meldred. You watch the children. They're literally just, like, trying to mulch Joe, who just swung a sword at the green light that. Makes you so much creepier with the face paint. I'm just over here doing this.
Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah.
I'm just thinking at this point, Vipera is just like, justice was served. Like,
I'm also over here going, I don't go to haunted houses for a reason and costumes spook me.
I don't even have my fangs in.
No, that would be worse.
Because you don't have the list anymore.
Yeah. So Joe's down there. Are you doing anything, Meldred, as these children are...
Do something.
Do it. Do what your character would do.
I'm not calling off the kids. I'm not. No bothers given.
I just love how green turns purple on the fucking screen.
So the kids are grouped. Can I...
They're just literally stabbing and stabbing and stabbing Joe's body.
Okay, so they're doing that. What
okay,
is the... Okay,
Trolls 2. Oh my god.
Oh no.
Look
oh
at
no.
her. Wait.
No, it's... Oh my god. They're eating her.
And then they're going to
eat me.
Oh my god. Anyway.
Okay, yeah, it's a terrible move because the trolls, which are not trolls, turn people into plant matter so they can eat them.
I because they're vegetarian, and I concentrate. I see that, and I'm like, "You're not going to do this. We tried to save you." And I extend my hand, and I start chanting in Druidic. And then there is a beam of light that shoots from the heavens.
Are you casting Moonbeam?
I'm casting Moonbeam.
Oh.
On the children.
On the children.
Boy!
They're hurting my friend!
You realize I'm going to kill you.
What? Okay, so...
Like, finish your turn.
We might not have much work to do.
Okay.
All right. What, okay. So what?
The I gotta finish. Like, I can't fucking back out of this.
No,
now.
No. You've crossed the Rubicon.
You do not do this to friends and people who have tried to save you. And then I cast Moonbeam. And Moon. I shoot the beam down, and I'm like, get away from friend right now, or else you will die.
All I'm hearing is Druidic, right?
Huh?
All I'm hearing is Druidic.
No,
all you're hearing is Druidic.
No, no. You hear, get away from friend right now, or else you shall perish.
It's not going to be enough.
Okay.
Yeah, it does.
You hear, for the first moment, Druidic, yeah. But when it comes to... You must pass out, or you must get away from our friend, or you will die. You do hear that.
Uh-huh. So you're threatening my kids.
I am threatening my kids.
Oh, he is fucking up your daycare.
Yeah. All right, so what's the damage?
Okay, so let's...
bloody my hands are about to get.
Well, let's see what this
with
is about
potpourri.
To be.
Already got Moon.
With potpourri. Every time you attack Medrid, just fucking patchouli.
When a creature enters the spell area for the first time on a turn or starts,
they'll take a Constitution saving throw.
That's a 4.
2d10. Right.
Yeah.
2d10 right.
How
here.
Big of an area?
It's a 5-foot radius, so it's not
around Joe, so
it's
that's...
not to
Joe,
hurt.
You're going to fail a death save.
Okay.
No, I'm not hitting him. I'm just
They're crawling on top of Joe.
Yeah.
Can I try to
No, they are, okay.
That you centered it on
dozen
me.
Or so kids but are literally on top of him doing this. So, Joe, you failed 2 death saves.
Oh,
I'm not trying to kill him.
I know, okay. But you dropped a moonbeam.
So sad, too bad.
So, but at the same time, you kill half the kids with the moonbeam.
I see the kids drop.
You watch the kids fucking vaporize.
Immediately, I'm turning
so,
on Joe.
So next is that is your go.
Yeah, I'm turning to Meldred and swinging hard with the glaive.
Okay.
Cool.
I really like the lighting effects. Do you want to use these at your house?
Good.
Wait, no, you don't have the right type of fan.
Not hurt.
No, because you got to strap it.
How's a 15 sound, Meldred?
Just barely.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. Wait. Before we, right. We get into this, like, what is my HP at?
Wherever it was beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
So 42?
Yeah. Y'all okay. Not rested.
Okay, so. Yeah, you hit.
That is a big old 7.
Yeah, I took a lot of damage on that fight, so it was immediately down.
And immediately after, we're blowing the spiritual weapon.
Bonus action spiritual weapon.
Mm-hmm.
You put this out there.
Okay.
Throw it on Madrid. Of course. There will be damage. Oh, there will be blood.
there will be blood. By the way, not a bad movie.
How about 18?
Y'all know that hits.
Mm-hmm. Mm, sure it does.
Shit, this is getting vindictive.
5 more
damage. Mm-hmm.
Nanny Tiefling about to fuck everybody up. 7.
And, yeah, I'm right in her face.
Okay.
You're not wearing contacts, right?
Correct. These are just my regular contacts.
Okay, because they're actually catching the blue of this and going yellow.
Blink, blink, hello.
Don't do that shit to me.
Death save. Last death save.
Death save.
They are killing friend. What are you
You're doing? Killing children!
They're killing face. Friend.
Okay, so you say they're still stabbing you, so,
Death.
Huh?
Death, that's...
So, yeah, so,
Oh, hello.
Grab your stuff.
All right.
Oh, my
oh.
God. Oh.
What is happening?
Fun times. grab your stuff and make sure it's on this side of the...
Okay. Got the dice to stay.
Take Joe off the map as the children, the remaining children keep stabbing.
No. Okay.
Okay.
My friend. He's my friend.
I'm right up in your... Like, I'm basically biting at your nose. Like...
Okay, also give me a concentration check for your moonbeam.
Okay.
Let's do this. I can barely see. I'm very sorry.
Roll it on the table so you're not dealing
with
shadow.
Wait. Can you look at this just to make sure?
Yeah, that's a crit.
Crit concentration on the moonbeam.
Oh, you're good. That's still holding.
So the kids are going to take more damage the next
time? No. It's not that they're going to take more damage. It's just you don't lose concentration. And they just... You watch them stab Jolene to death.
They're killing friend.
You're killing children!
Moonbeam is still there. Roll damage for Moonbeam. Unless you choose to move it. Because, I mean, it's still...
I'm going to move...
Well, hold on.
Okay, wait.
Explain Moonbeam to me, because it's a spell I never use.
I just had it.
Your phone is over there.
Oh, here it is. It's a
silvery beam of pale light shines down in a 5-foot radius, 40-foot high cylinder.
Is Mildred still intoxicated, or they've died a few times? Like,
it's hard to say.
It's no longer. They are no longer intoxicated.
Okay. When a creature enters the spell's area for the first time, or in the start of its turn, and is engulfed in ghostly flames that causes searing pain and must make a constitution saving throw. On each of your turns after you cast a spell, you can use an action to move the beam.
Use a full action, not a bonus action?
Just a full action.
Slide the map back this way a little bit, y'all.
So I'm not going to move
it. I can't. It's...
It just stays there and still does damage, though, right?
I don't think we can move this. It's kind of suction to the... Okay.
So I'm going to do something different. I'm gonna be.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be what they call very mean.
Well, I mean, the moonbeam damage is still gonna be. Let's slide it back a little bit more because I want this blue light to hit what happens when I drop it. Because if you look at the screen, shit's glowing, y'all.
It's all, I think it's also on top of your book.
There.
Yep, there it is. It's on there. There it is.
What are you about to do that's so very mean? So that we can all feel like terrible people at the end of this night?
Yeah.
I definitely do.
I don't know about y'all. I feel good. I'm defending kids. Like,
I'm legit the devil at the minute.
I mean, I'm neutral evil, so...
Another one?
Yes. I've literally had children get killed, Kyle. I need a beverage. I'm over here the most wholesome in the group, maybe.
What are you looking for?
Chris is looking for the right dice to fuck shit up.
Like, I've kind of got the glaive, like, as a brace against Mithrid's chest kind of situation.
I just wanted to save our friends. They shouldn't have hurt us like this. I'm very sorry.
The kids are traumatized.
And I press into your face, and I cast Inflict Wounds level 3.
Okay, roll to see if he can hit. What'd you roll?
17 natural.
Oh. That's it. 16. Yeah.
Okay.
You are looking for a...
Kyle's in there getting me a beer, talking about happier days. Glory days.
Wait, where did I cast Inflict Wounds?
Yeah. Third fucking level.
I'm sorry, I feel so bad about it. That's
5d10, dick.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to play a character.
No, my thing's over here. They're doing my work for me. Like, I'm not an evil DM, but shit, this is fucking honey. This is ambrosia.
I don't like this.
Out of game, why did Jolan attack me?
First person to 5. First person to 5.
I don't get it.
Insanity.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm sorry you got mulched by kids. No, it's fine. Spencer, this is like the third game I've killed you.
Yeah, the third character.
I'm sorry.
This character's died a few times in this game. Like,
yeah. No, this is like literally the third character that I've killed with Spencer. It's like, I hope nobody on the internet's assuming anything.
Sometimes it does.
I love
fall
Spencer.
Just
Spencer's
the right
one
way.
Of my friends.
The dice fall in just the right way sometimes.
Shit, no, Chris has almost killed me so many times with Uldrick.
No.
What'd you get?
I got 39.
I'm still up.
Oh.
And you're about to die, bitch.
Just all of a sudden grabs your face and you just feel the energy pouring through you.
It's fine. I recognize it. I'm good.
Roll for the damage to the kids, though, from the moonbeam. Because it's still going... What is the best noise for Moonbeam to make?
Turbine.
Just going. Or is it the one named Sailor Bean?
It almost is just a Madrid feeling escalation.
18.
Rest of the kids are dead.
Do I hear any screams?
You see the turtle kid. Emerald.
Like, I'm gonna look over my shoulder.
You look over, you see him about to stab one more time, realizing that...
And we got Thanos.
The body is dead, and try to throw the sickle at Madrid, and just dust it in front of you.
Okay.
So, Vipera, it's your turn now.
Of course it is. We're going to... That sounds tasty.
Oh.
I feel very bad.
Give me a wisdom save.
I cast Tasty Missile at third level.
Give me a wisdom save.
Flavor Town in the face.
Oh. Mel literally gives.
Sunshine might be done.
I'm sorry. Like, I feel very bad right
now. Give up then.
I want to, but I gotta go with character, you know. Holy fuck. Holy shit. Okay, so one second.
I'll take that 5.
This is not the dice you
will
see.
Will you hurry up? I'm gonna start a timer.
So that you are gonna do this like car battle timer rules. You got a certain amount of time.
Okay, so what did you say? Wisdom save?
I'm looking at who survives this shit.
Same.
I'm gonna let you...
Bloody hell. Fine, I'm stabbing at you again.
I got a natural 19.
Oh, no, I can't. That's an action.
On what?
On a wisdom save.
Okay, so Moonbeam's still there.
No.
I was trying to bestow curse.
Oh, so you fuck.
And
you said fuck off curse.
19 plus 6.
So you said fuck off curse.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So you went to bestow curse. So
spiritual weapon.
Okay, spiritual weapon. Go attack.
21.
That hits.
And...
Exactly.
Yes.
25. What are you...
Hmm?
What's your bestow curse? Or, not your...
What's the damage from your spear?
I'm grabbing dice for that.
So it's a D8?
11.
11?
Mm-hmm.
Are you still up, Madrid?
I am still up.
Okay, so what you're doing is you battle amongst dead friends and children. It's your go, Madrid.
We don't have to do this.
killed 6 children.
12.
You
the tree just spoke. Goes, 12, actually.
The tree just said 12.
There was, said there was a, like a half dozen.
Yeah, there, no, there was a dozen children. Half of them died the first round.
No, no, no. When, before we left the lake, you said I had a half dozen.
I know, I said he had a dozen.
Wait, did I get a drink?
Let's just, go with all the kids are dead. We'll whatever number you decide right now.
You killed more children in 30 seconds than the hags killed in months.
They killed our friend.
No, they killed like 30 of us a month.
30 seconds. Seriously.
They killed friends.
Snapping my teeth in your face.
I don't care. If you want to turn this into some sort of petty bickering, I don't care.
If talking is a free action, how much talking are you going to do? Because I'm going to stab you again.
Oh, if
what
you...
are you doing, Madrid, with your turn? You've hit the free point. Y'all can sit here and fucking anime monologue all you want, but somebody's got a Sharingan, someone's Rajagon.
I saw him.
Someone's got a Ro-Ro fight the power.
Okay, so...
It's all funny games, so somebody uses Byakuya.
Inflict wounds again.
Okay, roll to hit.
What's your AC?
16.
I got a 17.
Damn it.
Roll that beautiful inflict damage.
Okay, so it's 4d6.
What level did you roll it at?
I'd roll it second.
That is 4, because it normally does 3.
4d6, or what is
it? Okay, it's 4. Okay, you normally roll 3 dice. At 4th level, or 3rd level, or sorry, 2nd level, you roll 4 dice. So mm-hmm. you're rolling
4d10.
4d10.
Basically, unless you get min damage all the way, it'll probably drop me. Because I'm sitting at 13.
Shit.
But I'm going down with your blood on my hands. Like, I don't care. You killed children. I'm killing you one way or the other. I will come back as a zombie and bite your face.
Have I caused everybody to need therapy?
No, not therapy. This is therapy. What are you talking
18,
about?
18, 19, 20,
I'm down.
21, 22, 23,
24, 25, 26, 27, 28.
So that's a save. She's still dead in front of you. What do you do, Madrid?
I'm sorry, friend. I cannot... You are a very good person, and I cannot sit here in good conscience end your life. However, I can walk away. And I take his body, and I start trying to...
There's not much left. It's pulp.
Oh, no, no. You go to pick up, and it's literally you pull up bones out of slush. And it's not even full bones. It's chipped and brittle. Like, Jolan's head is still there. But the rest of the body is being pulled out of a slush of flesh and mud and viscera. And you get, like, as you pick up Jolan's body, it is just broken ribs, a clavicle, death save.
18.
That's the second save.
I get angry.
Friend's dead. Kids are dead.
We could have gotten out of this together. You decided that kids were more important than our group. We are all dead now. I stab her.
Oh, roll to see if you hit.
Okay.
Hulking out over here.
13 plus my dex.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No. 17, 16?
That's 2 failed death saves. Mm-hmm. As you, that would give me a death save.
This is the first time I've been in death saves the whole game, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look, I said horror campaign. I'm sorry, y'all. Like, I'm goofy as fuck, but...
I don't like being this character.
That's a success. So you... That's a third right. success?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You stabilize, but you're unconscious.
That's fine.
Madrid, what do? She's breathing slowly as if she is asleep. I love how dramatic this is. Look at the fucking camera with Chris's hair. Just like... What happened? All the drama last goddamn episode. Thank you, Hewitt.
Sleep. Maybe we can reconvene later.
What way do you go after you say that? Do you follow the trail or do you wander into the woods?
I take my time traveling into the woods.
Okay, are you following the trail or just off into the woods?
Following the trail.
Okay, so everybody move your character. I'm going to say, do me a favor, roll me a D100 and your fate will be decided.
Fuck it. I didn't want to kill your character, by the way.
67.
You awake with 1 HP, bloodied, perforated, huffing. Ooh. It's cold. As you awake, you're seeing the desiccated skull of a turtle being chewed on by some canine-ish creature that then runs off with it, alone, in the mud. Middle of this god's forsaken whatever you were brought to. Everything hurts. You feel lesser. No one's near you as rain slowly starts to fall. Roll me a D100.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
I'm not.
90.
Oh, I mean, hell, a lot of horror there.
I'm not going with what the book says.
Uh-oh.
Vipera, it's been a rough, rough moment.
Oh, gee.
No, I'm just picking up the freaking minis that hit me in the ass. Like, the freaking Wendigo hit my butt cheeks and just said, clap them cheeks.
You are not Thunderclap.
No, no, no.
It's time.
No. Okay. Okay. I'm out from the hoop. Where did I put the remote?
The remote.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this so that we can time out from the whoop. So, I think my child's actually crying for my mom. Or my wife. Give me a second to check this.
Oh my god, I feel so fucking... Oh my god. Like...
So to be fair, Vipera's backstory, she fell in love with a guy, she got pregnant, she told him about it, he was engaged to somebody else, he actually poisoned her and she miscarried.
Oh,
okay, that's fucked up.
And she went to go and confront him with her dead son in her arms, and was confronted by his affiance, who basically said her hubby would never be with a snake like her.
Oh.
And she blacked out and woke up with blood and a pile of bodies at her feet.
To be fair,
kids are her broken point.
Medrid is stupid.
Medrid is reckless. I understand. Like, Neysa understands that. I hold no fault with you, Chris.
Yeah, they do.
But like, Vipera, if no. Here's the thing, she's on a tilting point now of either just get the fuck out, go back to her home in the middle of Neverwinter Woods, and just try to regain control, or give in to the bloodlust and hunt you down. That's the tilting point right now. Huh.
Like, holy Dewey shit. Out. Like, it's so out. Fucking Dewey. Good. Because I was like, what should out. I do? Because, like, okay. Should I go with you? Or should I... Like, okay, so I already lost one friend.
Yeah, no,
in
I...
this. And then...
Your character choices make sense.
Spooky battle.
Yeah. And, yeah. And
they make sense. I have no problem with the way you played it.
Right.
But Vipera... It's a tilting point. She's either going to hunt you to the ends of the earth, no matter what it costs her,
you
or
did
she's going to
kill
give up.
Like a whole, like, you killed like a whole pre-K classroom.
To be fair, they killed his friend.
To be fair,
that friend threw a knife at me, like.
Swung a short sword and then got knifed by, like, gremlins out of nowhere.
Gremlins that I rescued from.
And then y'all just killed all the kids. Way to go, people.
I didn't kill the kids.
You are evil. So, Vipera, we're gonna continue on with you before we move on to anything.
Okay.
The rain's starting to fall.
I rolled a 90-something or other. You said you weren't going to do it, and you're knocking pillows over.
Okay. So what it is, I'm not doing what it said. Yeah. You awake, and you feel like you're in the mud for a moment, the cold. Children's bones around you. Some canid.
Ran off with
part of the torso skull. Then all of a sudden, you're in the rocking chair on your front porch at your...
At my cabin?
Yeah. Out in the woods. Bloodied. Your weapon damaged and rusted like it's been centuries since you touched it, leaning against the wall. If you reach up to feel your face, you don't remember this face. It's wrinkly. Your horns feel heavy. Do you look in a mirror? Do you get up and go look in a mirror or some reflective surface?
Yeah, I'll go to my spring pond.
Your horns are overgrown, almost curling back into your own skull. Your face is wrinkled. Your already white hair has laces of gray in it.
You don't know what happened. Do I remember Morteweald?
Passingly? Like a dream? Maybe it was real? Maybe it was just the delusions of an old individual in their silver years.
Would I remember the brooch, the cloak pin?
It's there.
Is it tarnished? Or is it the bright colors almost, that my father ghost in my dream gave it to me?
It's almost blackened. Like, past the age of patina to the point of probably it's going to rot away. It's almost useless now.
Do I hear the song?
No. But you hear a sound that has scared you for night after night after night since you got older, and that's the sound of wolves getting closer, smelling frailty and feebility. And you feel it's only a matter of time or either you have to go deal with other people, or the wolves are going to get you.
Is it daylight, or is it dark?
Late afternoon, heading into twilight.
I want to wait until after dark, and I want to go out and question the moon.
Okay.
Was it all a dream? Was I really
there? Are you casting commune?
I don't have that. Like, I don't
know. So you're
just
questioning the moon? Roll me religion for this question.
Twenty-two?
No. It was real. Years ago. You're just remembering it.
How did I get back?
Inconclusive.
Nice.
Try again later. Shake that magic eight ball.
Ask again.
Okay.
Am I getting the Mufasa treatment? Okay.
Chosen by one. I'm sure I'm like one of maybe two people that know what the fuck that's from.
If I go back in my house, is there anything that... Nothing.
As you go through the house, it's familiar yet not familiar. There's food that has not spoiled. but it's not the food you remember being in there. It's comfortable, yet uncomfortable, if that makes sense. Like, as you walk in, this is the place you've been at for well over 100 years, but it's not the place you remember that you left. You have memories that are conflicting. And I'm sorry, Vipera, I'm going to leave you as a confused older woman in the woods with wolves at her door. And your situation's going to be left unsolved for now. And maybe it's okay, maybe it's not. Medrid, you follow along this path for so long. An eternity, it almost feels like. And you come upon a grove. Are you okay? Chris?
My friends.
Method act.
Method acting. Hey, look, it fucking glows on the screen. Yeah. This is dope.
Teeny wee Medrid. Medrid.
Medrid, you keep coming. And eventually you're in knee-deep muck just crawling. Take a point of exhaustion.
You're so gonna die.
As eventually you get through this grove. And before you is this massive weeping willow that has like slightly neon effects on the top.
Hewitt is so happy for it.
I didn't expect it. I wish I had a better camera so it looked cooler. But
it looks cool. It looks plenty cool.
Like us playing, this like looks like blacklight kind of dope.
Yeah.
But Medrid, you come before it. There's ruins around you. You see a fallen series of stone, and then all of a sudden this immaculately beautiful fey woman flits through, a hand caressing your face and then disappearing off, and goes by a tree. My dear, is this the new you? Is this the one you chose?
There's
a real, a weird echo comes off, and as you throw your hair back, Medrid, and look up, you see this massive weeping willow in this almost psychedelic grove. It is incredibly dark, yet lit. Everything has this weird translucent around the edges, and you see Jolan and Preacher and Thunderclap.
She's back.
Them thighs are back.
Out in this glowing green, like they're translucent, but it's like every edge that they had is lit by sprites as they move through.
Yeah.
And hanging in the tree is this withered, decrepit, aged, elven? Not quite elven. Too elven to be elven. Fae. Not fae. High she. Beautiful, even in his decay. Desirable in his complete desiccation. A grotesque beauty beyond compare. Give me a wisdom save as you stare upon this individual in the willow tree.
Confirm it.
The elder sign is a nat 20, bitch.
Yep.
So you nat 20 resist?
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't add a mark to you. But you just hear, and I'm going to ask two players to follow suit after I do what I'm saying, because you are now part of this, because you were devoured by Morteweald.
I'm dying. The world feeds from me. This world, if I die, dies.
The world is dying.
Preacher just failing. Dear the headlight.
Act, boy, act.
To be fair, there's improv is fucking hard.
Especially death on is this upon one. Us, but this tree have gave us life.
It's not the end.
It's not the end. If you join,
you can come join us.
Become one.
You replace me. The world may live.
How are you doing that?
Hurting the fuck out of my throat.
I'm wondering.
Join us, Adrian.
I have done this for millennia.
Tell me, Elder Three. What of my friends that I've formed in this journey?
They are one with us.
This is our home now. Join us.
Join us, Dave. It's nice here, Dave.
Interesting.
We could make it a nicer place.
We can make stew together.
We fell when I no longer had strength to stay in the vague wild. I lessen every day. The mist takes more and more.
We need more energy, Madrid.
You can drop the voice.
Give us.
I really can.
You can give us your energy.
This is a most prosperous offer.
Replace me, Coven Hag. True Hag. True She.
You see the figure offer its throat to you about 15 feet up the tree and go,
take it. Kill me, please!
Oh, you want to die? Is that what you want? You want death? You want to suffer no more, pathetic fool!
All of a sudden, you watch the head turn and these bright, vibrant, bright red and orange eyes. These eyes of the Seelie Court stare directly upon you. Wisdom save.
It's hard to see. 17 plus wisdom.
Yeah, that you save. Listen.
I am going to die, child, no matter what. But if I do...
You're going to die, and I'm going to enjoy it. You fucking loser.
And with that, the reality winks out, taking Medrid into oblivion with it. As the Green Knight dies, taking the reality to true death with him, and all within it die. Morteweald slowly disappears from your memory as you look over everything in your cabin. You never went there. You once traveled into the woods and killed a tainted dryad. You had friends who were absorbed into the great dark tree. That was years ago. A lifetime ago. Maybe a story someone else told you from their adventures when they came through and you did business with them. Because you're that one house before you go into the deep woods. And that's where our dark fairy tale ends this evening. 3/4 of the party absorbed and taken into oblivion with the realm of darkness, the realm of dread, that failed as its Hi-Shi battery died. Medrid, no name, nothingness around you other than one eye that looks at you sadly, disappointedly, and then winks out as you're slowly absorbed by the void that is around you. Nothing else happens.
Preacher. We will have another chance.
Preacher, you watch as Paylor's light slowly recedes from your vision. You feel the arms of your Eidolon, now known as Pity, not hey. Thunder, not known as Thunderclap, but as Pity, as you sink into oblivion slowly, and then nothing. Jolan, you hear one last blast of the horn of a hunt before nothing. Over. So I hope you all enjoyed the game, everybody.
Okay.
We're all dead.
Excuse me, I'm alive.
You're alive. Hell yeah. You live. I'm dead, but you're in the live game.
So I hope y'all enjoyed the spoopy game. It finally kind of nailed itself at the very end. Everybody enjoy?
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. This good. Was...
Can I ask?
Yes.
What would have happened had we all shown up?
Who if would have we had been all choice? Shown up, the two individuals with the highest number of marks
would have been
made an offer, and then you would have actually had a battle if people refused. But the thing is the Dreadlord of Morteweald was dying, wanted to die, and wanted someone to replace him simply to save the people who lived there.
Oh, hey, Madrid's not actually dead.
No, you're straight up dead. Like, you got sucked into oblivion. This world no longer exists.
But I still got a bunch of letters, bitch. Fuck you.
You exist in a singularity of knowledge.
You're now in your own pocket dimension, just looking around going,
stoop.
I can find friends. My
you just start making puppets so you're fucking Laudna? Yeah, fucking run with that, bro.
No, I'm going to
literally the three of you that did not get out died. Yeah. Like there is no redemption from this.
No.
Like, I get that.
I am spending the next 1,000 years finding these two assholes and
trying. I don't care what they come back as. I'm just going to bring them back.
You're going to attempt to become a god.
So, for anybody that watched the game, thank you for watching our spoopy game. Mm-hmm. I finally got super spoopy at the end.
Yep.
I'm really glad I dropped in the dope-ass lighting effects on the break. I think it helped.
This has been a blast.
I hope all the players enjoyed. Sorry, I killed most of you.
No, I've enjoyed this game.
No, I'm legit saying this is the first time I've killed 75% of a party.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So now, okay, so
here's your
extra
little boy
life,
child.
For our extra life event. I am now tempted. We're doing a high noon, which is like level 20 characters battle it out.
Battle Royale.
I'm tempted to bring in this character because now we got.
I said do it. Wait, would we have? That's the question. Is during high noon, it's supposed to be at avatars of ourselves getting.
It's a simulacrum that get copied at some point by some individual.
So would we have memories of each other?
Somewhat.
Like, I'd know you from somewhere, but I wouldn't know.
Y'all discuss. I gotta go pee.
I wouldn't know why I feel so gross when I look at you.
Oh my god, I want to do it now.
I think we should.
Oh my god, I want to now.
I think we should. I don't think we got to see enough of what we could do.
The next game you play Medrid in, because I want to bring Preacher.
Well, bring High Noon.
I need that summoner class.
I have not had enough high-level games to play in High Noon.
Well, neither have I. That's the fun.
I've not had a single character get above level 10.
That's the fun. You get to just one-shot it.
Yeah,
let's
that one-shot battle.
Nah,
you just
and
test
then
it.
There are like other games for just at the extra life, such as that the Monster of the Week game we are going to be, that I am hosting. Then it is also going to be that some other folks coming in hosting some more D&D games and stuff. And then at all of that, the proceeds will go to Children's Hospital called Batson out of just Jackson, Mississippi, that, you know, that that the price of just basically one trip a long with just at the surfaces there is just around $1,500. And basically that like, and then last year that we had raised that amount, so then that was basically equal to basically one family medical bill. And then that, you know, then that just please, if you can, donate to such this, that it's good, such to such this good cause, because that a lot of people do not have the means to help out and do what you can to help out for the kids.
Yeah, that it's no parent should have to worry about paying bills when their kids sick.
Exactly.
That's what it comes down to.
And the thing is, it's like last few times we did this, I'm going to get into
into
flame. Well, look at me. well, last time we did this, the past two times we did this, we did enough to get, what is it, MRI scan? Or we did enough to do GP scans, which is general practitioner, sort of general health.
Are you talking about what we did last time?
Yeah.
Last time, using my own bills as a example, is we paid for both the anesthesiologist and the cost of an MRI for a family. Now, if we're talking about extra life, so I'm going to go ahead and say, this is not going to air until well after our 24-hour campaign is played. But let me throw this out there. Anybody that's watching us live, Extra Life is a wonderful charity. All the proceeds in the Children's Miracle Network go towards the select hospital to use to give to families that have any need. And we all know in the hellscape that is the insurance and medical procedure
American
field of the American healthcare system, which regardless, left or right, everybody knows it's way too expensive for what the fuck it is. So I really don't want a single parent to worry about paying for a child's medical bill, because the last thing you should be have to worrying about when your child has to go in for a life-saving surgery or a diagnosis that could wreck your fucking Christmas is the cost.
Yes.
So we're going to be playing. So far, we've raised over $300. That's before we even play.
Right.
And over this weekend, the goal is to get $1,500. Now, if we calculate, the last time I double-checked, $1,500. $1,500. I just got told by Emily to stop yelling. The last I checked, $1,500 pays for anesthesiologist evaluation and MRI scan. Or pays for the cost a family would have to pay for an open chest surgery or a gut surgery. Which means, please support us. I don't care if you don't like what we do. I don't care if you think we're not child friendly, because honestly,
it's not about that.
We're not, but we are unchild friendly, not safe for work podcast that wants to try to make it better for people to be able to have their kids
or pay for
the kids' medical bills.
It's not about us.
It is more like, so about helping the kids.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Like, it's not about us.
Now, even though this is going to air after everything, and I can clip it out or not, but Friday, the TBA crew is going to be running Bear Nun Mutual and Trust, a honey heist, Wild West bank robbery, followed by Critter Showdown, a creation of my wonderful, beautiful, creative wife, Frey. That is, we play anthropomorphic creatures dealing with the invasion of a gang. Saturday, Topher and I will start the whole gig off with Violent Ribbon co-DMing a steampunk level 3 campaign.
At We're going to kill everybody.
Knox is going to be running the wheel, which I think... Is everybody at the table right now going to be in the wheel?
I'm going to be in the wheel.
I'm in the wheel.
I don't think I've double-checked what... I mean, I could be if there's space. Like.
Okay. So we're going to do a Wild West post-apocalyptic type game, and then at 6-ish, 7-ish, I'll be running the 925... or the 925 to Harmony Ridge, a Call of Cthulhu train murder mystery. And later that night, our own Frecky V will be running Crash Pandas, which will be lit.
Mm-hmm.
And then Sunday, Ninjaspence is going to be running the Horror on Armistice Hill, which I think several of us in this table are going to be playing in.
Oh, yeah.
Then we're going to do High Noon, a level 20 showdown smackdown.
I'm going to kill everybody, but except I'm going to kill myself first.
I'm going to be over here trying to figure out the moral conundrum of what the fuck just happened.
Oh my goodness, everyone is dying. I guess I'll just off myself.
And then we're going to have Devin's game, which is with the system I'm not familiar with, but I'm ready to learn it, because we are gonna make characters right before we play that shit. Okay, the official sign off is High Noon. However, we got two games after the official sign off because we've all been to anime conventions. This is closing ceremonies, and the shit still happens.
Party. Ain't no party like the after party.
Ain't no party like the after party unless you gotta leave because of COVID. Right. Any case, so I believe that our good Zeta will be running our very last game, which is a Monster of the Week game.
Oh my goodness, I'm going to be running a Monster of Week game. It's going to be in Wild West format. Oh my goodness, it's all red now. You're going to be in what is called a minor town, where you go in and everyone is dead. Everyone is going to die.
Excellent.
Which is fun because, you know, I don't care. You die. It makes the game shorter.
I'm definitely going to play Pazari for that.
Oh, I'm going to jump into that game if it actually happens. The other thing I'm going to throw out there is if any of our games end early, we have some backups, Laser and Feeling, Stone Crows, Goat Crashers, which is you are a group of goats who are crashing a party.
Oh, God.
Because you were not invited, and goats should have been invited, and I cannot think of a better reason why.
A Wild West wedding. Oh, God.
You've been invited to the wedding of 1,000 Ways to Die in the West, and now a group of goats are going to kill the whole damn wedding party.
Hell yeah.
Including Mr. Building. Any case, so we got some things in the wind. It's also going to be us hanging out because, let's be honest, especially because Zeta and I have known the Lafayette crew for damn near a decade. We are going to have family here. This is about to be a big family reunion, playing D&D, new family, old family, making all one family, and we're gonna enjoy this.
And our Cajun brothers and sisters from down south are fucking. They're just.
Oh, they're nuts as shit.
They're,
you had thought that we were
crazy. Favor got problems. Favor got problems. Dude. Any case. Yeah. Everybody, thank y'all for watching. Mm-hmm. I hope my players had fun with me killing them. And mm-hmm. all is one, everybody. One, two, three.
Don't let your meatloaf. Thank you.